Next, let us discuss what are the different cases of simple harmonic motion. There are three cases of simple harmonic motion. One is free oscillation, next is damped oscillation, and then the third one is forced oscillation. Any body which is set for oscillation, if keeps on oscillating for infinite length of time without any force which is trying to bring it back to rest, then such oscillations are called as free oscillations. So, the amplitude in case of free oscillations will remain the same for any interval of time. In nature, there are no free oscillations. The next one is damped oscillations. Normally, what oscillations we see in nature, like the swinging of a swing or a simple pendulum or the oscillations of a spring and so on, are damped oscillations. Because if you observe, once the body is set for oscillations, then the body will oscillate for some time and then slowly it comes back to the rest. That is, its amplitude will be large in the beginning, then as the time goes, the amplitude goes on decreasing and the body will come to rest. Such oscillations are called as damped oscillations. Now, if we have any body undergoing oscillations, then if I want to keep it oscillating for long interval of time, then I can make it so by using an external agency and I force the body to go on oscillate for a long interval of time because of the external agency, then such oscillations are called as forced oscillation. So, we will discuss these three type of oscillations in detail. The first oscillation what we know is the free oscillation. In case of free oscillation, the equation of motion for simple harmonic motion of a freely oscillating body is same as that of the general solution of simple harmonic motion what we have discussed earlier. So, the same equation, that is d square x by dt square plus k by m into x is equal to 0 is the equation for motion for a body undergoing free oscillation with k as the force constant, m is the mass, and then we know that for such a oscillation, the angular frequency can be given as omega is equal to square root of k by m. So, what we have discussed earlier for simple harmonic motion general solution, the same holds good for free oscillation. So, we know that there are no free oscillations undergoing in nature ideally, because one or the other kind of resistive force will act on the body to bring that back the body to rest. However, if you consider for small displacement and for small damping, that is almost negligible damping, and if we consider for a short interval of time, the simple pendulum oscillating or the mass suspended to a spring can be considered as free oscillation, but for a very small amplitude. So, such oscillations can be considered as free oscillations. So, if we have to define the natural frequency of oscillations for a body executing free oscillation, we can say that it is the one's own characteristic frequency with which the body always assumes spontaneously to oscillate under the influence of a restoring force after it is getting displaced from the mean position and will be left free for oscillation. That is, immediately what frequency the body attains for oscillation after it is left free for oscillation is called the natural frequency of oscillation of a body. So, we can define free oscillation as the under the action of a restoring force, an oscillating body oscillates with undiminished amplitude at its own natural frequency as long as no other external force intervenes its motion. Such oscillations are called as free oscillations. The next topic what we are going to discuss is about the damped oscillations. As discussed earlier, in damped oscillations, when a body is set for oscillations, the body will keep oscillating for some time, and then as time elapses, the amplitude of the oscillation goes on decreasing and later the body will come down to rest. This is because in this type of motion, the body is subjected to combined action of both the restoring and resistive forces, and the motion always gets terminated with the body coming down to rest at the equilibrium position after a finite interval of time. For example, simple pendulum. So body is set for oscillations, and then because of the resistive forces in the medium, the body will slowly come back to rest. So other examples, if I have to give, it can be electrical oscillations like in LC circuit, in which the circuit is closed just after the capacitor is charged, or a swing left free to oscillate after being pushed once. Then the swing slowly comes back to rest. So let us study about the theory of damped oscillations, or what is the general equation of motion for damped oscillations and the solution for it. For this, consider a body of mass m executing vibrations in a resistive medium. The vibrations are damped due to the resistance offered by the medium. So such a resistive force is always proportional to the velocity of the body, and it acts in a direction opposite to the movement of the body. So if the body is moving in a certain direction, this resistive force will act in the opposite direction. So we can write this resistive force is equal to minus R dx by dt, where minus symbol represents that it is acting in a direction opposite to the direction of the velocity of the body, and here R is called as the damping constant. We know that the body is constantly acted upon by the restoring force, which is making the body to undergo oscillations. So this restoring force is given by minus k into x, where k is the force constant. So the net force, or the resultant force acting on the body, will be equal to minus r dx by dt minus kx. So these are the two forces acting on the body. Both are in the direction opposite to the displacement of the body. So that's why minus r dx by dt and minus kx. So now, as per Newton's second law of motion, we can write this resultant force as m into d square x by dt square. Equating this equation 1 and then 2, we get m into d square x by dt square is equal to minus r dx by dt minus kx. Or we can rearrange this equation as m into d square x by dt square plus r dx by dt plus kx is equal to 0. Now, this is the equation of motion for damped vibration. If we divide this equation throughout by m, we get d square x by dt square plus r by m dx by dt plus k by m into x is equal to 0. We know that the angular frequency of a body undergoing oscillation is given by omega is equal to square root of k by m, or k by m is equal to omega square. And let r by m be equal to 2b. Now, substituting these two, say in this equation number 3, we get d square x by dt square plus r by m is 2b dx by dt plus k by m is omega square x is equal to 0. Let this be equation number 4. Now, the solution for this second order differential equation will be, that is, if you solve this equation, you are solving for x. So x will be equal to Ae power alpha t, where a and alpha are constants. So now let us find out what is the value of this a and alpha. So let us first find what is the value of alpha. So in order to do this, let us differentiate this solution for x. So let me call this solution as phi. This is the solution. Differentiate this equation with respect to t. So we get dx by dt is equal to, a is a constant, e power alpha t, and differentiation of alpha t is alpha. So we get a alpha e power alpha t. Differentiating again, we get d square x by dt square is equal to, a alpha is a constant, and then e power alpha t and differentiation of alpha, that is alpha square. So now we know what is x, what is dx by dt, and what is d square x by dt square. So let us substitute this is in equation number 4. We get d square x by dt square is a alpha square e power alpha t plus 2b. Dx by dt is a alpha e power alpha t, and then omega square x is a e power alpha t is equal to 0. So further solving this equation, we can see here a e power alpha t is common here. So a e power alpha t into alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega square is equal to 0. Or we know that a e power alpha t is x. So it can be written as x into alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega square is equal to 0. Now, if you observe this equation, this is x into another term is equal to 0. So if this has to become 0, either x should be equal to 0 or this term has to become equal to 0. If x is 0, it becomes a trivial solution. So x cannot be equal to 0. So that means alpha square plus 2b alpha plus omega square is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation, and the standard solution for alpha, what is the value of alpha, will be minus b plus or minus root b square minus omega square. We have found what is the value of alpha, but it has two terms, that is minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square, and minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square. Since we have found what is alpha, let us substitute that in the equation number 5. So therefore, equation 5 becomes x is equal to, since it is two terms, a will be written as c e power minus b plus square root of b square minus omega square into t plus d into e power minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square into t, where c and d are constants which have to be evaluated. Now, in order to find what is the value of c and d, let us consider the condition when we are counting the time from the point where the body has taken the maximum displacement position, that is some value x0. At the beginning of the time, that is when time is equal to 0, we are considering the position of the body to be at its maximum displacement. So at t is equal to 0, x is some maximum displacement position x0. If I substitute for t equal to 0 and x equal to x0, this equation, say equation number 6, becomes x is x0 and t is 0. So it becomes c, that is e power 0 is 1, plus in the same way here it is d. Let this be equation number 7. Now we know that when the body is at maximum displacement position, at that moment the body will momentarily come to rest, because that is the point where the body returns to the other direction, that is
if you consider a simple pendulum and the bob has gone to the maximum displacement position, there the body will momentarily come to rest and next it will take the direction in the opposite direction. At that point, the velocity of the body will be zero at maximum displacement. At this condition, dx by dt will be equal to zero. That is, velocity is equal to zero. So, if we differentiate equation 6, what we get is dx by dt is equal to, differentiate this, c is a constant and differentiation e power of some a into t will be a into e power at. So it will be minus b plus root b square minus omega square e power minus b plus root b square minus omega square into t plus d into minus b minus root b square minus omega square e power minus b minus root b square minus omega square into t, and this dx by dt will be equal to zero. Now, since t is equal to zero, when dx by dt is equal to zero, we will substitute for t is equal to zero. This equation becomes c minus b plus root b square minus omega square and e power 0 is 1 plus d minus b minus root b square minus omega square is equal to 0. Now, rearranging certain terms in this equation, we get minus c into b plus c into root b square minus omega square minus b into d minus d into root b square minus omega square is equal to 0, or I can write minus b as common here. It will be c plus d, and then I can take root b square minus omega square as common here. So plus root b square minus omega square into c minus d is equal to 0. Or I can also write c plus d as x naught, because we know c plus d is x naught. So it is minus b x naught plus root b square minus omega square into c minus d is equal to 0. Or I can write c minus d as b x naught by root b square minus omega square. Let this be some equation number 8. Now, we know from equation number 7 and 8, we can get the values of c and d. So, if you add equation 7 and 8, what we get is 2c is equal to x naught into 1 plus b by square root of b square minus omega square, or c is equal to x naught by 2 into 1 plus b by square root of b square minus omega square. In the same way, if we subtract equation 8 from 7, what we get is 2d is equal to x naught into 1 minus b by square root of b square minus omega square, or d is equal to x naught by 2 into 1 minus b by square root of b square minus omega square. So we have solved for constants c and d. So in the first solution, what we got, x equal to a e power alpha t, we have found what is alpha, and because of alpha we found that the constant a k has to be divided into 2, that is c and d, and we have found that what is c and d. Substituting all these constants back, we get the general solution for equation of x as x is equal to x naught by 2 is common in both c and d, so I take this as common, into 1 plus b by square root of b square minus omega square e power minus b plus root b square minus omega square into t plus 1 minus b by square root of b square minus omega square into e power minus b minus square root of b square minus omega square into t. So this will be the general solution for damped vibration. So if you observe this equation, you will see that as t varies, x also varies, and as root b square minus omega varies also, x varies. So let us discuss how the variation of square root of b square minus omega square affects the value of x. So for this, we have to consider three cases again. First is when b square is greater than omega square. Then next is when b square is equal to omega square. And the third case is when b square is less than omega square.